family. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory, 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 oh, glory, glory.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day.
Good morning. Welcome to Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. You know my voice already. It's Leyvon, mother. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for letting me join you. I don't have a clue what it is that you do at 11 o'clock, but whatever it is you do, I'm happy that you're doing that, doing that. You decided to do that, do with me. You know, if you've been listening to me, that I intended to talk about the orange economy on Wednesday and Friday of the month of December. However, I do not see my guest, who is Giovanni Stewart. So if you see him, you let him know that I can't find him in this studio because we're supposed to be talking about his movie that he's actually making, he along with the people down there at Stewart's Cove, or that he's supposed to be in, The Shark Whisperer. And it's because we're trying to figure out whether or not some of these things that we talk about with regards to the orange economy are even really possible. Is our economy big enough? How do we break into these things? What are some of the hurdles or red herrings that may get in our way, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so since my guest isn't here, I guess I'm going to let you guys have an open line. You can talk to me about some things that you want to talk about. That's fine. And I'll talk to you about some things that I want to talk about. I want to say this. I am an eye for Tanya FNM. Does that make sense? That is the call sign under which I identify myself. I am an eye for Tanya FNM. And so every time I see Hubert Ingham pop up in the newspaper, every time Hubert Ingham makes a public utterance, because, you know, he does this thing where he comes out and he speaks and then he disappears, right? And he comes out and he speaks and then he disappears. And he's like the phantom, right? Like the phantom of the opera. And so I see that Sir Franklin Wilson made some comments in the newspaper about Mr. Ingham. And Papa said, you all must see the guy display. You just feel like you could say anything in the newspaper but me? Oh, absolutely not, man. Let me tell you all what happened. And so Papa's in the newspaper this morning. So when I got up this morning and I saw that Mr. Ingham was in the newspaper, every time I see Hubert Ingham, every single time I see Hubert Ingham, here's what happens in my head.
Come to me wild and wild. day. Every day. Mm-hmm. In your eyes, I get lost. I get
I'm gonna
lost.
I'm going to go up and just like kind of envision him now doing the awkward, because he has this awkward hand wave that he does. It's very awkward. The thing of his kind of very awkward with the hand waving. His hand wave and smile, they don't coordinate very well. So it's like, bum, bum, bum.
You're simply the best.
And so that's what I hear every single time I see Hubert Ingram name pop up in the newspaper. I can't help it. Every time they say Ingram, I hear Tina Turner. That's just kind of how the way it works. There's a story here in the Nassau Guardian this morning says, Ingram defends Quarton Bay approach. And it is a story by Travis Cartwright Carroll. It says, in a rare public rebuke, former Prime Minister Hubert Ingram yesterday shot down allegations by Sir Franklin Wilson that bad public policy by his administration in the late 90s was the reason the Quarton Bay Resort in South Eleuthera failed to proceed. On Monday, the Davis administration signed an amended heads of agreement with Quarton Bay Holdings for the development of $200 million resort, which is expected to create 500 jobs. Sir Franklin, who owns the Jack's Bay development in South Eleuthera, told the Tribune that the owners of the Quarton Bay were ready to go, but bad public policy and governance, this is what derailed this thing in 1986 and 1987, and in my humble opinion, triggered the recession Eleuthera has not come out of. The story continues on to A6 in The Guardian, today's Guardian. It says, but Ingram, who oversaw the first House of Assembly, heads of agreement between Quarton Bay's owner, Dr. Carlos Sarmiento Angulo, and the government in 1986, fired back. Ingram explained that Sarmiento, with the approval of his government, purchased the former Quarton Bay property from Sir Franklin. He subsequently converted the old Kaiser residence into his private family retreat in Eleuthera and commenced plans to redevelop the old Quarton Bay Resort and Golf Club, he said in a statement. Those plans to renovate, upgrade, and expand the Quarton Bay Resort have disappointedly not moved forward during the past 25... not due to any action on the part of the Free National Movement government. I was surprised, therefore, to read, and I take exception to, reports that Sir Franklin Wilson spewed misguided accusations that my government's bad public policy in the late 1990s were largely to blame for the lack of action on this project. I have long expressed frustration with slow progress in invigorating the South Eleuthera economy, which was a goal of every government led by me. Contrary to Mr. Wilson's allegations, FNM governments have consistently acted to marry their interests to providing increased economic and employment opportunities and hence better living conditions for ordinary Bahamians with those of attracting desirable investors to our country. With specific regard to South Eleuthera, my government, in an effort to facilitate Dr. Sarmiento's redevelopment plan for the Quarton Bay property, acquired and redeveloped the Rock Sound Airport, much to the chagrin of its owners from the Franklin Wilson Group. Thereafter, a new airport terminal was constructed, and we put in place plans to expand and increase electricity and water supplies to accommodate the development and to provide services to residents of South Eleuthera. In office, the FNM always sought to protect the interests of all, public and private. Where conflicts between the two arose, we always came down on the side of the public interest as opposed to personal private interests. So we did not approve Quarton Bay Holdings Limited application to buy substantial additional land from the Franklin Wilson Group prior to the commencement of development on the large acreage already owned by the company for the express purpose of touristic and upscale residential development. We were satisfied that additional land was not required for the size development proposed, and further, we did not agree that foreign entities or persons should be approved by the government to purchase large tracts of vacant land without specific approved development plans. At all times, Dr. Sarmiento, with whom I met at his invitation at his office and at his home in Bogota, Colombia, was fully aware and accepted that the government that I led would not approve further purchases of large acreage of land in South Eleuthera by him until unless he progress the agreed development. From the point of view of Sir Franklin, this may be called bad public policy. From my point of view, it is the exact opposite. Ingram said that Sacramento has always come to the table to negotiate his agreement for development in the Bahamas with the FNM administration. It suggests that Dr. Sacramento is satisfied that the FNM administrations would deal with him fairly and transparently, he said. The former prime minister said it is instructive that the development did not proceed under either of the two last PLP governments. The outcome of the general elections in 2012 and 2021 resulted in two of the Sacramento group agreements approved by the FNM government being signed by a PLP administration, he said. Notably, that meant to bring the Four Seasons hotel chain to South Eleuthera in 2015 was agreed during my third term in office, as I announced ahead of the 2012 general elections. At the time of the general elections, details concerning road deviations, zoning, land use changes were being discussed with the developers, as well as the processes for dealing with construction permits, work permits, supply of power, water, communication, and custom duty exemptions under the Hotel Encouragements Act. The project, while signed by the Christie administration, did not move forward as anticipated. Similarly, it appears that the negotiation of the agreement now signed by the Davis administration was negotiated by the last FNM administration. I wish the development great success, and I look forward to its beneficial impact on the people and economy of South Eleuthera. In his comments to the Tribune, Sir Franklin said, the way they treated Sacramento, the father, there was no explanation for it. It was terrible public policy. Those people were ready and willing to go, but bad public policy, Those people were ready and willing to go, but bad public policy and bad public policy and governance, this is what derailed the thing in 1996 and 1997, and in my humble opinion, triggered the recession Eleuthera has not come out of. If it's for real or not for real, it's not because of Sacramento. It is because of our government, and in particular, our government in 1996 and 1997. This is what the terrible governance of that period triggered, the depression in South Eleuthera. These are great people, people of the highest standard, and who the country should welcome with open arms. The question of whether it's for real is a function of other things. It isn't a function of these people. The new heads of agreement for a Ritz-Carlton brand that will have 90 rooms and 60 villas, according to Cotton Bay Holdings manager Daniel Zuleta, Minister of Tourism Chester Cooper said, the project will do wonders for the economy and the landscape of South Eleuthera. So you see those two men there have got into a little public spat. Former Prime Minister Hubert Ingham said he don't have the slightest clue what Franklin wasn't talking about. Franklin must be losing his head, because it couldn't have been me. Every time the man called me, I went to the meeting. Not just to the meeting. The man invited me to your office, invited me to your house. And by the way, the two deals you all signed for mobilization, both of them were drafted under the FNM administrations, which means these people always like doing business with the FNM. What is also notable is when you all was the government, I never remember hearing them coming to no table about no negotiations. Either they didn't like Perry or they didn't like somebody in the room, but you can't blame Ingram. So I don't know what's going on with you all. Please leave me out of that. I've not been prime minister for 15 years. I'd like to stay in retirement, basically what Mr. Ingram has said. And Mr. Ingram has said, listen, in the rare occasions where public policy conflicted for the best public or private interest, it is my job as prime minister to side with the people. But don't say that I didn't try. I build your airport. I buy that. I build it. I build a new terminal. I put more water down there. I put light down there. What else y'all want? But you want me to go sell the man one bunch of property. He ain't got no development plan approved. He ain't got no drawing approved. Nothing approved. I just must give him a bunch of land. That can't happen. And so now the deputy prime minister and minister of tourism is saying, well, what a wonderful delight. What an absolute majestical delight it is that this group has come back and decided that they wanted to do this development in Eleuthera. And let's see what it turns out to be. Who knows what the Sacramento family will do down there? I don't know. But I'll tell you this, though, right? I learned this one thing from McElpine during his last term in office. I really don't care too much about heads of agreement signing. It don't really matter to me how much of these things you all sign. What I've come to learn from governments in the Bahamas or from governments that I've had the opportunity to watch is head of agreement don't mean nothing. Head of agreement is like saying trick a little flicker on too. It don't mean nothing. Heads of agreement is saying that the governor of the Bahamas signed the heads of agreement is the same thing as saying to me that Peter Piper will pick a pack of pickled peppers. It doesn't mean anything at all. And unless, because don't forget there have been several heads of agreement signed with the Lugayen property. There's been a head of agreement signed with the Ginn Development Group, and all kind of other head of agreement signed around this place. They sign head of agreement all the time. You remember in opposition, the then leader of the opposition, now Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Bear Davis, signed a MOU again with the, what are those people called? The union people. That didn't mean nothing. McElpine say, show me the money. That's what to do. You keep talking about $200 million, and you all think you're all slick, right? Because $200 million sound good. Over a period of 5 years or 4 years, this is about $40 million a year. That ain't really no money. I hear you all say you all can hire 500 people, but I ain't know about that either, because Mr. Ingham say you all talking about work permits and all kinds of things. So out of the 500 people you all hire, this might be, give or take, 120 payments, maybe. Who knows? Y'all definitely could bring in all the auger workers. They could be imported labor. Don't tell me. I know. Ain't much Bahamians around here doing auger piling. Right? So those fellas are all going to be not Bahamian. Right? Don't forget, when y'all been look, casino down in Bimini, that was one fistful of Mexicans. So I hear the whole 500 job thing. Sure. Great. Whoop-de-doo. And I always take a bit of umbrage when I see people get very personal about investments that the government blocked, because I don't believe that any prime minister that has been prime minister of this country has negotiated in the worst benefit of Bahamians, right? Albeit the last prime minister made it difficult to believe that sometimes. I still believe that every person that has ever held the Bible and has sworn allegiance and attestation to the crown acts in the best interest of the citizenry of the Commonwealth. I am naive enough to believe that. And so show us the money. When the people put the money on the account, put the money in the bank, then you call us. And let us know that the money there, and let us know that they breaking ground and not just chucking shovel in the sand with six fellas with some coat suit and hard hat. When will the development land? The people of Elutra could use it. That would make a whole lot more sense than two old men in the newspaper rowing all morning about who was bad at what and what was good for who. I think that is what the Bahamian people would hope to see, particularly in these very rough times in the Bahamas, where we could use a jolt to the economy in any way that we could have it. All right, outside of that, I see that there is another, what the old people would call, backing and forwarding going on with regards to the carnival. The newspaper reports this morning, Darvel says no decision yet on carnival. But Memenzo, who bring the carnival, say, what do you mean? I don't understand no approval. Explain that to me. I talked to none less than Prime Minister Davis. Man, who else I should talk to after that? You think I should go talk back to any minister? No, man, I talked to minister number one. And he say, I could bring the carnival. So I don't know what you're talking about, Darvel. Don't tell me nothing. He say, we've been to Mexico. We've been all up and down America. Ain't nobody dead when we's doing this. What you mean I can't bring this to Nassau? Man, y'all, let's don't play crazy. I didn't put up the fence. We having the carnival, and you're all going to need to sort of the paperwork. But Michael Darvel say, hold on, brother. You look like you're losing your head. Don't lose your head too quickly, all right? Don't lose your head too quickly. I in charge of safety protocols, and you ain't bring no hotel here or no hospital here. So that means if you cause an outbreak, I have to worry about where the house people, and I know if I won't fool with this. And so that is going to be quite a kerfuffle. I think they're going to meet today with regards to what's going to happen with regards to the carnival. But I want to tell you where I stand on it. I feel like they could never ever bring the carnival back, and I'd be perfectly fine with that. I think the carnival has taken enough money out of this country over the God knows how long to never need to come back. And since we're talking orange economies, right? If you're going to create an orange economy, well, isn't the carnival entertainment? Have we figured out a way to make that Bahamian yet so that Bahamians could create a carnival that possibly goes throughout the Caribbean? So that Bahamians could create a carnival that goes throughout the family islands, so that a Bahamian group of companies could have
Because we have, what, 22, 21 inhabited islands in the Bahamas? Remind me. I don't remember. I think it's, is it? I don't think it's 20. It's 13 inhabited islands. Whatever it is. It's enough to have a carnival on every island every month of the year. You got Eleuthera, Exuma, Abaco, Grand Bahama, Cat Island, San Salvador. Who else got inhabited islands? Rum Key. Who else inhabited? Acklands, Maguana. But you don't need to take it to there because there's only 12 people down there. But well, everywhere except for Maykal. You could take the carnival everywhere except for Maykal because it don't make sense taking it to Maykal because they five islands break up with about 100 people over the five islands. And now you make it a national carnival. And we could give this to Bahamians and we could tell cousin them over here with the carnival, yeah, y'all don't ever come back. And then we have the grand carnival finale here in New Providence. And, you know, they swap out the rides every now and again. And now we could add that to our orange economy base. All right? So let's talk about some things. 323-622-3253-4316. 325-4259. You can call me on any one of those. You can text me on 422-4796. Let's take a call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there?
Hey, there, my brother.
Hey, JJ.
Boy, you want you this morning. See what happening to these politicians and all these Christian countries and all these people who say they like us, and we know they don't like us. We ain't fooling, we ain't dumb. And here you say a while ago, boy, we know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Be smart on them. You know, we have a lot of educators. You know what say behind the back of that in this country.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a bunch of yes, men and women who fail in this country miserably.
Mm-hmm.
But that's what I keep telling you young folks. In 2027, the whole most people, 80% of them should be removed out of the way. They didn't fail this country.
Mm-hmm.
They swear their allegiance to the queen, her heirs, and successors. That's why they treat the women the way they treat us. Look at how the foreign banks and insurance comes to us. We're going to swear too.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all I got to say, my brother. But keep up the good work, my brother. You and Dwight, I'm doing a good job.
Appreciate it, JJ. Let's take another call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Good morning, Leyvon Miller.
Hey, what's going on, Robert?
Now, you let me get right. I'm on my new iPhone.
Man, I can hear you there.
Now, that I wanted to say, just above my pay grade.
Because
that carnival already here is setting up. So Brave you retired the new CA, but he's your boss. You're the new company authority. But Brave with the prime minister, somehow the carnival got connections.
He's
setting up. But I just try to say, you can think about it. Man, that's above your pay grade, Donald. Stand down, right?
No, but see, you have to understand. It, while I agree with you, Robert, right, it is above his pay grade. Once the prime minister speaks, that's the prime minister's utterance, right? Here's the problem, though. The problem is if the proverbial contuberance hits the perpendicular, right, this becomes Davil's problem. You follow me? So the prime minister says yes, right? And I'm going to repeat that for you again so you can hear it. If the contuberance hits the perpendicular, right?
Mm-hmm.
Guess who have this problem to deal with now? Michael Davil. He can't sleep. He got to stay awake every night. He got to find nice.
The buck stops at the prime minister office.
I don't disagree.
Remember that?
I don't disagree with you, Robert. All I'm saying to you is, if I am a minister, right? If I am minister of health and I have an easy peasy, lemon squeezy kind of time and nobody else dead and COVID, albeit still real, doesn't look quite existent anymore because the people them doing whatever they want to do anyhow, right?
Yeah.
And the hospital ain't filling up. And yeah, I got some nurses that leave in the PHA. But hey, you know, I mean, that ain't big news. Yeah. Right? Yeah, and yeah, now I haven't smooth sailing. Hold on, Robert. Now I haven't smooth sailing. And you want to talk about carnival where lone screaming and sometimes vomiting and sometimes all kind of other things is go on. Next thing you know, I have a massive outbreak. And guess who problem that is? And guess who ain't collecting an easy $90,000 no more? Me.
When
I'm not fooling with that.
Deal was made, Omnicon wasn't around. So they didn't expect Omnicon would have been here.
Mm-hmm.
But that's my only that chances. And, you know, let's get back at Papa back in charge of the FNM. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Papa back in charge. So Dr. Feckenstein ready to make a new monster. You know, he had slayed the first monster he made.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he tried to put Dr. Science back in the office, but did you realize when science first run the FNM, Papa and them did not get along.
Mm-hmm.
No, when he started to do them, when he went to Elizabeth, and Papa said, you can't talk for them, and him must talk for them.
Mm-hmm.
So all him and Papa get tight now, since he's a doctor. So let's look at it. Dr. Feckenstein ready to make a new monster.
All right. Appreciate you, Robert. 323-622-3253-4316-325-4259. The fellow who in charge of the carnival named Joseph Albert, just so you all know, because I call him cousin. Cousin in his name. He's Joseph Albert, manager and coordinator of Midways by McCarthy is this McCafferty Enterprises. That's his official title. He said, what you talk about, bad Brave? Tell me, Cub. What you want me to say? I don't know what else you want me to say. I asked Brave. Brave say yes. I hear all my things here. Customs cleared them. So what you want me to do? The boat bring it, customs cleared, it on the ground. And that's another thing. The fella then on the ground, so what you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Are you gonna make him pack all that stuff up and carry it back? It's quite a kerfuffle, I will say. Anyway, let me read a couple of these text messages. This one here says, stop liking my... What did I say? Are you not a Hubert Ingham fan? I am quite a Hubert Ingham fan. Y'all could love Kobe. I mean, what the boy named LeBron James. I can't love Hubert Ingham. Yeah. I too invite you to stop liking man. This one says, listen, we don't want to hear anything from the Grinch, the former Prime Minister. We want the carnival. We don't want to hear no news to spoil our Christmas. We want the carnival. And tell Tenquest, hush up, we want the 10% VAT too. I agree with you. I don't know what Peter Tenquest talk about. I thought he was going to just, you know, dissipate. You know, evaporate. Politically, of course, right? Because I don't really think Peter Tenquest has any more political collateral left. I mean, I don't know. I don't think he'll survive another 10-year cycle before he becomes completely irrelevant in politics. I just don't think he's going to be a political superstar. That's all I'm saying. So I thought he would kind of like, you know, fade back into private life, but he obviously wants to. He is still deputy leader of the Free National Movement. Let's not forget that. This one here says, come on and leave and wear your face mask and safe distance. Let's go, carnival, go on. Let the carnival go on. Well, I don't go to carnival anyway, quite honestly. As a matter of fact, I don't even understand what is the hype. I don't really care for the carnival. I don't really know what people is go there to do. People say they go for the pizza, but it's not that grand. And outside of the ability to not be discriminated against in my country and gamble, that's the only reason I go to the carnival, and I need to do that. I could go to the local community watering hole. They just do that there too. That must be the carnival as well. Mr. Miller, you play the jingle again. What does it say, Mr. Miller? You play the jingle again. It remind me of the sale of Patelco. Really? This one here says, please see if you can get the percentage of success of the last shock treatment. I'm not interested in talking about shock treatment today. We keep getting the same failed people and program without seeing results. Show the behemoths, the past percentage. Okay. Maybe this is something you should take on as a personal thing. I don't know. Hello, Mr. Miller. I absolutely love this song by Tina Turner for Papa. He is simply the best. I tell you, as soon as I see Papa, when I see Ingram, if Ingram come out and sing the ABCs, Mr. Ingram, of course, former prime minister, if he comes out and sing the ABCs, I just want to listen to it. I don't care. This one here says, morning, Leyvon, speak louder or turn up your mic. Is my voice not clear? Can you hear me now? Fantastic. All I say is, they better make sense in governance because the Bahamian people ain't playing with them. The populace ready to kick them. You know I can't say this word on radio. Out. Let's take a phone call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Good morning, Leyvon.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, I was happy that Mr. Ingram clarified that because as an Eleutherian, I know the situation up there so very well. Mm-hmm. It has nothing to do with the F&M government. Absolutely nothing. And that's the reason why nothing was done during the rest of the party as well.
Mm-hmm.
It has something to do with the investor.
Mm.
That's where the problem was, and I ever was.
Mm-hmm.
He was not, in my opinion, he didn't deserve to even have that land.
Mm. Well, and that's what Ingram was saying. Ingram said, listen, y'all ain't bring me no drawing. Y'all ain't bring me no.
That should have been revoked from him years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I back Mr. Ingram 100% on that. He's right. Absolutely correct.
But that ain't what Sir Franklin said. Sir Franklin said it was bad. And you notice how many times he used the word. It was bad public policy and bad governance. That's what Mr. Franklin says.
All right, my baby. All right, but,
appreciate
all right,
it. Bro. All right, let's take another one. Come on and call it. You're on. Turn your radio down. Listen to me in your headphones. Come on and call it. You're on.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I am blessed and highly favored. How are you?
Man, equally blessed and as equally highly favored.
Good. Very good. I listen to you often. I appreciate your thoughts and your programs. They are very good. Most of them are very, very good. But one thing I want you to bear in mind, I want you to take consideration to and of, is Patelco. Many Bahamian people will never, ever forget that. So find out, he's researching on random. The person who did it said they tied it up so much until the Bahamian people will never get it cleared out.
Mm-hmm.
And that is hurting to us as a nation and as a country, and we'll never, ever forget it. Thank you so much for listening.
I appreciate you very much. My difficulty with people that say that they oppose the sale of Patelco is this. Some of the only people I know who got plenty of money around here that are regular people are people that were bought out in the Patelco deal both the times, right? Like, I know some fellas who are comfortably sitting at about $500,000 in liquid asset, and that is because of the sale of Patelco. They're ordinary Bahamians. That's one. Two, when I ask Bahamians what about the sale of Patelco irritated them so much that they wanted to see the back of Mr. Ingram, many of you cannot, in plain language, communicate that to me. You don't know if you mad because he sell the company. You ain't sure. Because since the company has been sold, it's been sold about four more times and y'all ain't mad now. Some people argue that, oh, well, they sold the infrastructure, which is a reasonable argument. But I mean, how much does that affect your everyday life as a Bahamian? That's the second thing. The sale of Patelco led to the creation of Alive. And there are, I mean, the people over there say that that company grew exponentially within its first 2 years. So obviously that was something you all were happy about. What exactly is the frustrating factor in the sale of BTC that annoyed Bahamians to the point that they needed the FNM going? And Mr. Christie, in his, you know, magical way, went back and got the invisible 2%, right? You know, like the invisible nickel? Mr. Christie went back and got the invisible 2% that we don't really know what's happening with it or where it is, but he got it back. And still you all aren't happy. So the government somehow possesses 51% of the company now. There is a competing company. Patelco generates more money now for the Bahamas government than it did when the Bahamas government actually owned the entire thing. What is the difficulty? What is the frustrating, what is the boiling point in the BTC argument? That is the thing I don't understand about Bahamians and their frustration. But you can call me and let me know. 323-6232-325-4316. And I tell you, the fellas who buy in the most drinks at the Water and Oil is the ones that either get let go from BTC or BEC in the buyout packages. They got all the money. So that wasn't bad for Bahamians. What was bad? Think about this. Sugarfoot get a couple dollars out of that deal, right? The little tenderoni gets something out that deal. Huh? The biddy gets something out that deal. So there were several people that benefited from, you following me? You would have to then explain to me what made Bahamian people upset, because I don't know if they know. This one just says, good morning, Leyvon. Great show again. Only Papa and the counted again new leader, Pintard, can keep the FNM together to gain any leadership in the Bahamas in the next 10 years or 20 years. So all others should back aside. No more power for them. And this is from Grand Bahama. This one here says, we cannot have, people can learn without this. Again, if you feel this way, people can learn without this type of military infusion. We must stop browbeating of our people and learn how to communicate with them. If you feel that way, then I invite you. Carlos Reed sits at his location every day. He doesn't move. He's always there. Go and take to him your concerns and see how we can incorporate your concerns in the goings-on of the new shock treatment. But for as far as I am aware, it's a green light go. I trust that Senior Lieutenant Delvin Duncan is out there formulating a wonderful little plan. I actually want to go and watch it every now and again. Because what is more wonderful to watch than a little bit of bee sting, eh? Let's go to a break, Ali. Don't move. I've got more show planned for you on the next side of the break. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. We'll be back after this.
Here we go. J.S. Johnson Insurance agents are the best. Reliable service, we've been on the scene, protecting since 1919. J.S. Johnson Insurance has stood the test. Always. You're always covered me. J.S. Johnson Insurance. Peace of mind.
Hey. find the show interesting? Do you want to be a part of the conversation? Well, sponsor Unleashed today. Call 302-2304 or 302-2375 to see which package is right for you. Join Leyvon Miller as he ignites the passion of the next generation by bridging the gap with engaging conversations and innovative ideas. Take action and sponsor Unleashed today at 302-2304 or 302-2375 and be unleashed.
The new Guardian Radio app is here. Listen live to all our Guardian Radio shows and live video stream select programs in our studio. Get information about Guardian Radio shows and our hosts. Send messages, including text, email, and even call. All from our amazing new Guardian Radio app. Download it free today in your App Store for your Apple device or Play Store for your Android device. The all-new and improved Guardian Radio app.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Welcome back. Thank you for staying with me. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My phone lines are open. I was supposed to be talking to Orange Agona me today, but since my guest didn't show up, now we're talking about the news, all right? And I feel like you all always want to talk about the news, so I read the news often. I get to talk to you all about the news. You all could tell me what you all read. I could tell you all what I thought when I read what you all read, and we could figure it out. Because, you know, the news never really says exactly what it is that it says, right? The news kind of says something, but if you read deeper into the news, it just always says something a little different. I see that the travel visa is also going away. I want to sing the hallelujah chorus, right? Albeit I haven't traveled since the beginning of COVID. I really wasn't interested in that part of it anyhow. And I thought that it was fundamentally flawed that you could require a visa of any kind for citizens to return to the country that they bear passports for. All right? There is a piece that I read when I attempted college called Tides of Humanity. I recommend that you all go and read it because I completely believe that that is a wonderful piece that speaks about how all of these things are the creation and inventions of politicians, and they really do nothing for the upliftment of citizens of countries, right? And so I don't know where they got the audacity from to require a visa from me as a citizen of the country. But I thought that it was, again, fundamentally flawed, legally, first of all. And secondly, it was just offensive, right? So that has fallen away. The visa no longer is a thing. I hear the Deputy Prime Minister has announced that in the House of Assembly. Also, though, I will say this. I hope that we are now making the trek toward making testing something that is far more accessible. How will we do that? Michael Davil, again, I say to you. Engage the NHI. They have all kind of lab and all kind of doctors already on a payroll, and they already have a clientele. Each one of them got 1,000 people that they're responsible for. So all you do is you make sure the 1,000 people that just go to Dr. X all getting tested on a schedule if that is necessary. And all the ones who traveling ain't got to guess where they going. They going to their NHI provider who is going to keep a track of how often they've been tested and what was the results. And when they pop hot, we know exactly where to find them. We know what all of their comorbidities are, etc., etc., etc. And it's so much more linear than this whole ad hoc independent thing that we doing with people testing in back of the bush lab facilities that nobody know the name of, and all kind of new lab just popping up left, right, and center. And you following me? Let's see if we can make a bit more synergy here. You can call me, though. 323-623-2255-4316-325-4259. This text right here says, good morning. Great show. I'm not sure the carnival is a great idea. Given our situation, we don't need an outbreak. What is that people cannot understand? As for Mr. Ingram, he's just simply the best. The carnival took all their earnings out of the country.
Yeah, I agree. As a matter of fact, I think they could take their license now. I don't even think we need to ever bring it back, ever. I don't want the cotton candy either, FYI. Only thing I want to go to the carnival for, Ali, is to play over and under. That's it. And get a teddy bear for the bow. Nothing else. I don't care about, and I even didn't want the teddy bear because them teddy bears be dusty. I don't know where these teddy bears come from, right? Forget COVID. The dust on this teddy bear may make me sick. So all I want to do is go win up some money on over and under and not get locked up. Because if I play at the watering hole and the police come in here and I can't afford to buy it around, they may carry all ass. And I ain't into that. All right? And let me also say while you're at it, the nightlife is also opening back up. I think that that is also an interesting thing. While in my capacity as a justice of the peace, of course, you know, I was out on the weekend keeping the Queen's peace and making sure that there was no disturbance of the Queen's peace in and around the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, particularly the District of New Providence. And I have to admit that everything seemed very orderly, very orderly. I see that many things are opening back up. I visited the Hill, just again in my capacity as Justice of the Peace to ensure that good peace, law, and order were being kept on Saturday. It was quite a marvelous experience, and I think that's becoming a thing, right? So that's the new weekend thing, right? So, you know, local community watering hole ambassador / periodic Hill attendee, maybe, right? Maybe I'll do that. This is what they tell me. They say the reason people come to the Hill is because Jack and Jill went up that hill for water. People come to this hill for the sugar to go with the water. And so that seems to be a thing. I don't know. Who knows whether I'm in my capacity again as Justice of the Peace. I may have to go over there and make sure that good peace, law, and order is being maintained. And the nightlife is open. Wear your mask, and I invite everybody to get back to nightlife because that's how this economy can get spinning, and that's how I can start making some more money again because my life depends on the economy to move, and I ain't got no government job, all right? So give me a call, 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. That was good. Jack and Jill went up that hill to get water. They tell me sugar on this hill to go with the water. I really amaze myself sometimes. This text right here says, Leyvon, the carnival corn dog is on point. I don't want that either. Leyvon, not now. Let's keep it real. The BTC deal was bad. You can never justify the $204 million. Wasn't it $240? They got management control and all of the infrastructure and properties, and the government has to take care of BTC million-dollar pension fund. Leyvon, to top it off, Papa and Lang missed and left $59 million in the bank for cable and wireless. Shameful and disgraceful. Yes, but what about the spin-off effects? Have the spin-off effects not mitigated all of the things that you considered bad about the BTC deal? I'm asking. The people that were able to start new communication businesses, again, the introduction of Alive and the 51% shareholding in that as a government, the opening of the telecommunication services. Of course, you remember Alive came in here and they were working on the network, but that's no longer the case. Alive now has their own network. Well, in Nassau anyway. And so, I mean, there are some good things that came out of the bad situation. All I'm asking is, were those things egregious enough, right? Like, were they terrible enough for you to forever hold it against Mr. Ingram? He got 290. Y'all keep saying 204. I think it was $247 million was what the upfront purchase price was, if I'm not mistaken. And the government no longer had to pay salaries. BTC was able to do a restructuring, and the dividends of the company that is paid to the Bahamian government every year is more than they was making when they owned the whole company. So I don't know. Maybe we broke even, I guess. This one here says, Leyvon, I think more awareness needs to be brought to men's rights regarding what they can do or get done relating to documents for their children, accessibility to their children, hospitals, custody rights, all these things, instructions that have been used to emasculate and disrespect men in this and other ways needs to be reformed like yesterday. And that is from the PI. I don't disagree with you. Can I also say how happy I am that the father of little baby Bella is getting the remains of little baby Bella ordered by the court so that he could bury that wonderful little girl. You know, I sometimes question whether or not, if God is all-seeing, then how come he allows some things to happen to some people? And then every now and again, right, judges make the kind of rulings like His Lordship Lauren Klein made the other day. And it reminds me that obviously there is a God that sits high and looks low. Because
I mean, it is just a travesty what had happened to that child. And I can't imagine the mental anguish that would be visited upon that man if he couldn't have the remains of his daughter. And if you remember the interview, he said, all I want to do is take her back to Freeport and put her to rest. That's all I want to do. You know what I mean? And had he not been given the remains, more than likely, he probably wouldn't even have attended the funeral. And he would have had to teach his heart to accept that his not attending the funeral was somehow in the best interest of baby Bella. And people go through these things all the time. People don't attend their mummy funeral because them and their sister them can't get along. They don't attend their daddy funeral because them and their brother them can't get along. But to not attend the funeral of your child, because if I go to this funeral, I can knock one of these people block slack. It's something that I think you have to, I mean, it must cause your heart palpitations to have to consider that in the burial of your very innocent young child. So I'm very happy at the ruling of the court. And I think that I think his lordship ought to be commended for that ruling. I believe it was certainly in the best interest. This one here says, I read that already. This one here says, Leyvon, I read the board chairman's statement at the shareholder meeting. They paid $204 million. Are they mad? $59 million was in the bank. Okay. This one here says, I think our former prime ministers are graded or rated just as they came. Pinlan was simply the best. Then Ingram, Christie, lastly, Minnis, Davis, writing his legacy now. So give him a chance. I believe the prime minister now, Prime Minister Davis, is well on his way. I have to admit, he has either hit a streak of good luck or it must be Obia. I don't ever remember Mr. Davis being this popular, but he's like Gaston now. He's everyone's favorite guy. They gave him the key to the city of Miami the other day. I don't know what that was about. Not to mention, though, the former prime minister, if you recall, the former prime minister was voted man of the year two times consecutively, or two times in the same 1 year, and all he did was become prime minister and then became the most honorable. All this happened in his first 2 years in office. And so I say to Mr. Davis, listen, don't forget the same people that sang Hosanna was the people that sang Crucify Him. So watch these people, the people that love you, the ones that are taking the pictures with you, the ones that inviting you everywhere, the ones that making sure you don't miss nothing, the ones that have you to every function, all them people, I want to tell you, these people are the same ones that will sing Glory Hallelujah, Hosanna has come. And then you will hear them say, Crucify Him. And you will wonder, what happened? It's me, Brave. So all I can tell you, sir, is try your best to do your best always, and let's see where the chips land. Anyway, that sounds like my time. That's my music. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, the station for fresh news and smart talk. Don't move. They have the news. That's now.
And become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough.